Welcome to the Chelsea story, 91-92. With Bobby Campbell stepping up into senior management, Chelsea came into the new season with a new man in charge, Ian Porterfield. Porterfield immediately set about restructuring his squad, and there were several new arrivals at Stamford Bridge. Defender Paul Elliott came in from Celtic for £1.4 million. Tommy Boyd joined Chelsea for £800,000. And another forward, Joe Allen from Hartlepool, cost Porterfield £200,000. There were also several departures. Heading the list was Gordon Jury, who joined Spurs for £2.2 million. Left-back Tony DiRigo travelled north to Leeds United for £1.3 million. Kevin McAllister went back to Scotland and joined Falkirk for £250,000, while Dave Mitchell went to Swindon for £30,000. We kick off with a home game against Wimbledon, where the debutants play their part.
Down by Clark. Oh, there was a foot raised as Barton went in, but the goal is there for Fashanu. Wise to take the corner. Dixon. Chelsea player for 36 minutes in the First Division, and his supporters have a new idol. Dixon has wise delivered it perfectly again, and Elliott, whose power in both penalty areas is so important. Wimbledon with a clever approach work at the free kick. Fairweather took it, and Robbie Earle came round the back. Minutes to go. Lasso. Allen! Well, Ian Porterfield can be very pleased with his new acquisitions here. Elliott a scorer in the first half, and now he's sent on Joe Allen to do just that. Sharp. And Marshall is in behind Chelsea and has driven in the opening goal in the First Division at Boundary Park. Well, Oldham looking as comfortable on the grass as they used to look on the synthetic surface here. Rick Holden! And Chelsea at the moment aren't putting up a great deal of resistance. Header from Jobson. Curry against the bar. Curry again! Well, that crowns an excellent night for Oldham.
So playing it in once more. Dickens, the former West Ham player, retrieving it in the midfield.
Clark playing it forward. Wilson on the break now for Chelsea. Crossed in there. Dixon! And it's over the line! Kerry Dixon for Chelsea. Less than 3 minutes gone. Spurs were pierced down that flank, and as this cross came in, there's Dixon with too much space and a fumble by Torstvedt behind him and into the back of the net.
Paul Allen back to Terry Fenwick. And the line to Jury. Elliott sticking close with him. Puts it back to Allen. Well played in there. And Lineker, great save.
Terrific move by Tottenham, and inevitably Lineker with the head on the end of it. Just glanced it, and the ball was aiming for the corner of the net, with an excellent save by Kevin Hitchcock. Good reactions.
Naeem's cross, Lineker again trying to get away from Johnson, and did well to chest it down for Deary.
And here come Chelsea again. Lasso playing an early ball. Wilson's onside. It's a terrific goal for Chelsea. Look at the delight on those Chelsea fans' faces and on the face of the scorer as well, Kevin Wilson. But what a ball from Lasso. And Tottenham were split asunder. There's Lasso's ball, or rather, there's the shot by Kevin Wilson.
By Birmingham, but met firmly by Elliott. Up goes Dixon.
And away goes Townsend. A chance for number three now for Tottenham for Chelsea. 3-0, Andy Townsend. And once again, the Tottenham defence ripped apart. Terrific goal again, this time by the Chelsea skipper. Dixon's header down. Wilson again made the pass. And Andy Townsend finish it off past Torsvik. 3-0.
Townsend. Made in by Boyd.
And a total misunderstanding there, and it could be another one. Should have been another one there by Dennis Wise.
Can't account for this. Torsvik goes for it. There's a misunderstanding between him and Howes, I think it was. But Wise balloons it wide. Chelsea stay just three up. But here's Graham Lasso.
And Dixon, a wonderful goal. No, the flag is up. It's an offside.
It's a super bit of football, this. Lasso looking up. Dixon making his run and timing it seemed to perfection, but no, the linesman probably was right there. He probably looked as though there was a fraction of offside about it. First competitive game that Spurs have played here since they won the cup at Wembley.
Here's Lineker. Here's a chance now for them to get back into the game, and the ice cold finishing of Gary Lineker. Given Spurs something of a chance now.
Wise. So taking on Bergs and gets the cross in.
Terrific bit of play again there by Wilson. And it cannoned off the post, it seemed to me, and went behind.
Playing the ball in now with 3 minutes left for Andy Townsend, the skipper, being chased by Stewart. How well Townsend held him off there. Fix it then for Boyd. Back again for Townsend. Here's Dickens. Dixon. Alan Dickens. The cross comes in. Wilson's waiting in the middle.
Could be another one. No, they just squirmed it wide of that post.
Could quite easily have been goal number four. And a really good build-up there by Chelsea. The ball, in fact, fell quite kindly for Wilson, but he just couldn't quite make it over the line.
That's a good turn by Tommy Johnson. Got the better of Boyd. Elliott holds him up. Johnson's try is very effective indeed. Boyd and Johnson. And here's Bartlett. Oh, chaos! Clark and Hitchcock left in a heap. Bartlett left with an open goal. Townsend, Cherry coming for this. Oh, it came off. Craig Shaw to Elliott against the post. Elliott again! Well, there was chaos in the Notts County penalty area then when Andy Townsend kept the pressure on, hoisting it back in and saying, well, let's see what happens. Well, what did happen was Steve Cherry was ill-advised. He came off his line. The ball dropped off Craig Short's head. Elliot hit it against the post and then hit it into the back of the net. Wise. Elliot up the far post. Dixon. Allen. Allen! Well, this is becoming a habit. In his short Chelsea career, he's now arrived as a substitute twice. Twice in the nick of time. Dennis Wise with such skill on the right. Elliot headed it back purposefully. Dixon made a nuisance of himself. Allen kept going until he got his goal.
After that draw with Notts County, manager Ian Porterfield decided to toughen up his midfield and brought Vinnie Jones back to London from Sheffield United for £575,000.
Hitchcock with an enormous clearance, headed away by Roger. Lasseur made a nuisance of himself there, bodge Beaumont out the way and gives Chelsea the lead after 19 minutes. Well, he's not the biggest player on the field, but certainly the most athletic. Pembridge to take the throw. Neat 1-2 with Wise. Pembridge again. Chelsea get it clear, and a chance for Lasseur to run at the Luton Town defence. Splendid ball to Wilson. That's a goal for Townsend. 2-0 now to Chelsea. And the Chelsea captain gives them a stranglehold on this match. Dixon, he has a real chance to wrap it up now for Chelsea, which he takes. Great strike by Kerry Dixon. Clark to take the throw. Chelsea lead. A good afternoon's work by the home club. Jones throws it long. Wilson couldn't win it. Picked up by Steen. Probably Luton's most promising move of the match is Farrell. Farrell with a measured cross. Oh, the goalkeeper's missed it. And Gray pulls the goal back for Luton. But that has to go down as a mistake by Hitchcock in the Chelsea goal. Didn't have it again though. Roger. Pembridge. Townsend then for Chelsea. Boyd to his left. So helping it forward. Dixon now. He's stolen into the inside left channel and created the opportunity for Wise to make it 4-1. There's no way back now for Luton. Wise will take this corner for Chelsea. Two-handed signal normally means the back post. And indeed, it's floated to that position. And Elliott was fouled there by Dreyer. And a penalty to Chelsea and a chance to make it 5-1. Wise made it 4-1. Is this the fifth goal for Chelsea? Denied by the frame of the goal. and Chamberlain somehow scrambles it clear as Dixon follows up. Wilson lost the ball in the air, but Wise helps it forward. Townsend now, Dixon, he might score, he has, but the linesman's flag will deny Chelsea here. Lasso, nearly an hour gone, still no way through for Chelsea. Townsend. Jones calling for the ball in midfield. There's a little bit of space here. Boyd onto his unfavoured right foot. Dixon. Wise arriving. It's there. Chelsea have the lead at last. What a splendid ball played in here by Boyd. And the intelligent header by Kerry Dixon unlocks Sheffield United's defence.
It's broken, too small off Moncal. Oh, a marvellous try. And Foster, and it's turned in the end by Small. Given away by Small this time. Chelsea need to get numbers forward here in support of Lasso. And Dixon has got free, Kerry Dixon, 1-1. And Dixon chalks up his 190th goal in Chelsea's colours.
So an opening of mixed fortune still leaves Chelsea in fifth position, in touch with the front runners and looking to a place in Europe at the end of the season.
Strachan popping up on the right. Moncal just about got it clear, but early to McAllister. Here's speed now for Leeds. Cole shuts. Yes, Chelsea nil, Leeds one.
Wise with the corner. Usual stuff from Chelsea. Oh, Jones! His first goal in Chelsea's colours. And his old Wimbledon chum, Dennis Wise, supplied it with another pinpoint corner. Lasso, McGrath's gone across, but he can't prevent the ball coming in, and Jones! Wise. Allen, and here's Townsend! Well, it went through Nigel Spink. And Chelsea have two. We're 12 minutes into the second half. And Andy Townsend with another well-timed break from midfield.
Midway through the first half, still 0-0. And Queen's Park Rangers have this throw. Holloway calling for the ball. Might break here to Wilson. Yes! He gives Queen's Park Rangers the lead. Bartley with a free kick. They didn't pick up Peacock, who makes it 2-0. Nearly an hour gone. Wilson gets it clear. Townsend arriving. Oh, what a goal! It's one of the goals of the season so far by the Chelsea captain, Andy Townsend. A thunderous volley. Stayskull hardly saw the ball as it flew past him. But how about this for a drive? So, stoppage time right at the end of the game. Wise has done it! An equaliser for Chelsea right at the death. Moncal came forward for this long throw, and the acrobatic Dennis Wise makes it Queen's Park Rangers 2, Chelsea 2.
I mean, QPR was tremendous second half performance. We're losing 2-0, gave two really bad goals away. You know, dreadful goals. But the lads didn't get their head down, they kept going. And we got a goal that I think is probably the best goal we've scored this season, 90 times since. Marvellous volley, terrific goal to make it 2-1. And then with a long throw from Vinnie Jones, a flick on from Kenlon Cow, and Dennis Wise overhead kick into the roof of the net, the last kick of the ball.
Moncal beaten by Mike Newell. Fashika keeps the ball in play. Beardsley. Half away by Elliott. Beardsley again. Ebrell. Now Nevin trying to put on a show back here at Stamford Bridge. Ebrell. Oh, and it's gone under the dive of Besson. Good touch from Dixon. And Wilson. Can he reach it? And it rolls beyond Neville Southall and in! That was a brave piece of finishing by the Northern Ireland international as the goalkeeper of Wales and Everton came off his line. Watson tried to steer it back. Wilson anticipated and just got it inside the post for Chelsea's equaliser. Wise, Jones, not disguising his intentions. So, too strong for Nevin. Headed out by Keown. Clark. Townsend pulling to the left-hand side. And somehow he managed to keep the ball for Chelsea. And the end product is a header from Dennis Wise. And Chelsea have turned the game round in the second half. And it was more excellence and attitude from Townsend to make the goal possible for Wise. Moncal, oh, Beardsley, too sharp for him. And Peter Beardsley, with 4 minutes to go, scores for Everton for the sixth consecutive game and a very timely one at Stamford Bridge.
Here's Kerry Dixon then, away from Winterburn. Oh, this is a good run by Dixon. Lasso! Chelsea had the lead at Highbury. And the architect of that goal was undoubtedly Kerry Dixon here. Away from three red shirts. Ghosted into the inside right channel and they picked out Graham Lasso. Chelsea man forward here. They look for Lasso again. Lasso has it now. Dixon back defending. Wise. Wilson. Chelsea have a two-goal advantage against Arsenal. Wilson with his second consecutive goal makes it Arsenal 0, Chelsea 2. So Dixon with the long throw. Oh, it appeared to hit the hand of Vinnie Jones there. Penalty to Arsenal. Lee Dixon to take it. And a chance to put Arsenal back in the game. 2-1. Limpar with the corner. Wright's in there. Oh, that's the equaliser. 2-2 now. Campbell. Oh, that's a strike to win any game.
I can't remember any goals, I've only scored three. Probably Arsenal, the first goal against Arsenal, which unfortunately we lost that game, although I think we thoroughly deserved to win. It was a very enjoyable match and I was lucky enough to score the first goal. There was a nice picture in the Express actually where it captured me with my mouth wide open, screaming at the top of my voice, I think, because I was pretty thrilled that I'd scored.
Even though Chelsea's form continues to fluctuate, the Blues are still in sixth place, hot on the heels of the top five. The departures continue as keeper Roger Freestone leaves Stamford Bridge to join Swansea for £50,000. Meanwhile, Chelsea taste their first cup action of the season in the second round of the Rumbelows Cup against Tranmere Rovers.
Martindale, that's a fine ball to Thomas. Aldridge is there! What an impact he's having at Tranmere. 11 goals now this season. Come off the head of Vickers. Irons harassed out of it by Andy Townsend. Jones. Now Graham Lesoff. Wise. Lesoff's gone on ahead of him. And Wise ignores Boyd as well. Gets his cross in. Higgins. Wilson will retrieve for Chelsea. Still a goal down. Dixon pulling free. Wise. Townsend on the left foot! And in those situations, there's an air of inevitability about the outcome. Chelsea kept working away here. Terry Dixon got free, and Dennis Wise knew where Townsend was and teed it up for him.
That draw made for a tricky second leg. And things got even trickier when Jim Steele gave Tranmere a first-half lead with that textbook header. But on the hour, Chelsea were level. Kevin Wilson's deflected shot was going wide, but little Dennis Wise was on hand to poach the equaliser. Extra time now, and a controversial incident in the dying minutes. First, John Aldridge went down in the area. No real complaints about the penalty decision. But Aldridge's method from the spot left the Blues fuming. Worse was to come in the final minute of the tie. Rovers substitute Chris Malkin taking full advantage of confusion in the Chelsea box. 4-2 on aggregate, and an early exit for Chelsea. And it's back to some more league action, starting with the home game against Liverpool.
Liverpool's throw. Rush finding Walters again. Clark concedes another throw. What a windy day here. Swirling around, difficult to say which side gets the advantage as Liverpool attack dangerously here, and the shot goes in with a deflection from McManaman. Liverpool take the lead. Less than 5 minutes gone, and Steve McManaman, with the aid of a deflection, scores his third goal of the season. Wilson. Back to the 17-year-old. He did well to win the corner off Nichols. So Chelsea have won three corners in quick succession now, and they've looked dangerous from each one of them. But he's changed his mind this time, but it comes to Allen. It's in by Jones, the equaliser. The folk hero of Stamford Bridge has pulled them level. Once again, the corner did the damage. A different one this time. Allen's shot, kept out by Grobbelaar. Jones was following up to score. In the 10th minute, Chelsea have drawn level. Confusion in the Liverpool ranks, and Jones made the most of it. Clark's free kick, aimed at Allen. Went over everyone's heads, and they've got players in the middle here. Wilson is one of them. Wilson! Grobbelaar was in exactly the right place, otherwise Kevin Wilson's header would surely have given Chelsea the lead. Walters has found some room on the left, but McManaman wanted it played back. And it comes instead to Ross. Good goalkeeping by Hitchcock. On by Allen to Wilson, that's a good ball for Townsend. Score on his full debut, it's the second half. A corner inevitably brings Chelsea another goal. Burrows turning it in. McManaman's had a rush. Liverpool have equalised. Ian Rush gets his first league goal of the season to make it 2-2.
Ray, so didn't like that, but Ray did get to the ball, coming in with the arms flailing. Gabbiadini, neatly done for McGoldrick. Wright's in the middle, and Gabbiadini got his foot to it, and so too did Hitchcock. Well, suddenly, Crystal Palace found a flow to their football then. Gabbiadini involved in the outset, and wanted to round it all off as well. But look at that, Kevin Hitchcock kept his left leg in line.
Jones to take the throw then for Chelsea. It's Clark available. Abrisovic has dropped that one. Lissou, that could be Coventry's fourth consecutive defeat in the first division.
Bowen playing further forward today for Norwich. Fleck, well, it's fed in beyond the considerable reach of Besson. Gunn drives it long. Elliott and Lissou in each other's way. Jeremy Goss with a shot. Bowen follows up, and it's 2-0 to Norwich. Goss and Fleck is onside. Oh, no nonsense.
Tissier with a free kick. Shearer Riley! Southampton have the lead.
And now for some more cup action. This time in the Zenith Data Systems Cup, starting with the second round match against Swindon.
Jones with a throw. Clear by the Swindon defence. As he just couldn't get there. Hooked away by Kerslake. First touch by White. Allen scrapping for the ball. Oh, within inches of Chelsea's first goal. Myers, away that time by Calderwood. Myers again. He has it, couldn't win possession. Elliott flicks it on. Allen! Well, a gilt-edged opportunity here for Chelsea to take the lead in this Zenith Data Cup tie. Allen really should have done better. So stoppage time at the end of the game. But only enough for Vinnie Jones to find a winning goal. Chelsea had given up hope here when Wilson's cross was met by Vinnie Jones, who surely now has scored the winner. Ipswich pressing forward in numbers here. Stockwell, bit of space on the right hand side. Palmer, Kiwomia, 1-0 to Ipswich. Wise in a hurry to take the free kick, but Thompson won't let him. Clipped into Jones. Chelsea level after half an hour. Really good finish by Vinnie Jones, as that free kick was floated in by Dennis Wise. That one was telegraphed by Palmer. Kiwomia! That's his second of the night, and might be enough to send Ipswich through. Stewart, he's found half a yard now. Allen scored! Two substitutes combining effectively to undo the Ipswich defence. Wise with the corner. Elliott! And the crossbar denied him. Chelsea that close to going through to the semi-finals. It's it's reached a penalty shootout to decide who will go through in this Sunday Theta Cup tie. Wise with the first penalty, ably dispatched. Chance to draw level from the spot, effectively done. John Walk, the man on target for Ipswich Town. Kerry Dixon with a chance to make it 2-1. Chelsea's nerve holding firm. Here's Stockwell for Ipswich. Far too close to Hitchcock. And Chelsea now favourites to go through. Allen, whose late equaliser brought this tie to a penalty shootout, with the next penalty to make it 3-1 to Chelsea. They're in touching distance now of the semi-finals. Ipswich really have to score this one. Expertly dispatched. 3-2 to Chelsea on penalties. Vinnie Jones, 4-2 to Chelsea, and it means that Ipswich must score their next penalty to deny Vinnie Jones and Chelsea a place in the last four. Here comes Milton then for Ipswich, put away effectively. Could be all over with his spot kick now. Graham Stewart to take it. If he converts this penalty, Chelsea are through. Ipswich are still alive in the Zenith Theta Cup. Chelsea's first miss. Andy Linigan then with a chance to bring us level at 4 apiece. Hitchcock has saved it, and Chelsea progress into the semi-finals. Chelsea win 4-3 after a penalty shootout. Here's that save again. Hitchcock is the hero for Chelsea.
Back in the league, things aren't going quite so well. But things start to look up against Nottingham Forest.
Jones. Trying to get round Walker. Not for the first time in the game. Walker not having things all his own way. Graham Stewart certainly comes into the very promising category for Chelsea. It's going to be a Vinnie Jones special. Elliott. And it's brought a goal for Kerry Dixon. The barren spell is over. Jones acknowledges his part in it. And Kerry Dixon is back in business. Joy all round Stamford Bridge. The long throw from Jones, the flick from Elliott, the goal from Dixon.
Ian Porterfield decides to boost his firepower and brings in prolific goal scorer Clive Allen from Manchester City for £250,000.
Worthington with a corner. Hurst arriving! What a way to celebrate your 24th birthday! Chelsea has stretched here once again. Jemson is onside. He has Hurst in the middle. That's his second goal. Chelsea dreadfully exposed because of that double sending off. And here's Hurst again. He's on his hat-trick, remember. Elliott desperately tries to get back. Williams, 3-0 to Sheffield Wednesday. It's all over now.
forward for Hughes, and that was a shove, certainly by Paul Elliott, spotted by Mr. Courtney. Paul Elliott plays the innocent victim, but I don't think he had much of a case then. Hitchcock organising the wall. Erwin, who takes it right-footed. Oh, what a magnificent goal! Kanchelskis. Boyd very close to him, but he finds Parker. And it goes towards Hughes. Hughes just about controlling it. A clever little back-heeler. McLaren! Manchester United have got a second. Good work by Erwin. Hughes. They've got a player completely unmarked in the middle here. Kanchelskis is wide on the right, Hughes going all alone, and goes down, and it's a penalty. Clark's tackle, Manchester United get the spot kick. Steve Bruce hammers in his sixth goal of the season, Manchester United's third of the day, and surely now the points are bound for Old Trafford. Townsend. Wise takes over. This is Boyd. And there's Lasso outside him. In towards Clive Allen. It was an excellent header by Clive Allen. And he's kept up his record of doing well for his new teams. Although he got a little bit too angry then with Schmeichel, who he felt was trying to kill a bit of time. But nonetheless, that was a great header.
Chelsea freely admit that their worst performance of the season was at Oldham. A chance to wipe away some unhappy memories. Townsend. And Jobson. Well, there was maybe a push on him but by Dixon, but the referee, I think, has given handball, and it's a penalty. A penalty to Chelsea. John Haworth to try and stop Dennis Wise, but he can't do that. And Chelsea off to a promising start. Wise, who can really put them anywhere he likes, goes high this time. Back from Stewart. Clark keeping the move going. Wise getting his cross in quickly. Dixon, Jones! He really lined that one up and lashed it goalwards. He took some stopping. Elliott. With a solid header, the ball came from Barlow, who loses out now to Stewart. And away goes Wise, Jobson. Trying to get to him, can't do that. Clive Allen! ...26 minutes gone, and Chelsea sweep upfield for a second, and Allen knew exactly the best spot there. Great stop by Bessant, and then that's what goalkeepers want their defenders to react when the ball comes off them. And it was Steve Clark who stopped Oldham getting in and maybe getting back into the match after Richie's header was parried by Bessant. Played wide by Jobson. Now Holder. Richie glanced it on and Marshall made light of a very tight angle. Stewart, and Allen was trying to force it in beyond the far post. The outcome is a corner. Elliott! And Henry was guarding the post. And And this season, when handling on the line means instant dismissal, there was nothing much Henry could do. High was Elliott, and Henry couldn't match him. Barlow, who is an adventurous left-back. Here's Ritchie. Sharp. Clipping it in, and well met by Marshall for his second, keeping Oldham alive. Marshall getting the better of Moncal. Oh, and he went for the glory of a hat-trick. And he ignored Roger Palmer. Well, Marshall saw where Palmer was, but he tried to get it beyond Besant and couldn't manage it. So one thing about Oldham Athletic, as the first division is finding out, they're full of good attacking ideas, and even when at times in matches, as there has been here, they seem to be struggling, they can always swing it back their way. But here's Wise, now Dixon, Sharp helping out, Elliott, Oldham have pushed up, and the flag has stayed down. This is Graham Stewart, Allen is there. And the downside of Oldham Athletic is they always give the opposition a chance to score, and Chelsea have taken this chance with alacrity. Stewart sprang the trap, and once Allen gets into these positions, you know what happens next. Goal for Chelsea.
Chelsea's erratic form is beginning to be reflected in their league position as they slip down to ninth place. Things don't improve on their visit to Meadow Lane against strugglers Notts County.
Tommy Johnson and Phil Turner will work it between them. Here is Phil Turner now. Yates has got there and marked inside that Chelsea six-yard box. Charlie Palmer helping it forward. Johnson's on his way. Goal number 10 of the season for Tommy Johnson. James will be favourite to strike this one. Harvey. It was Harvey's goal. Tremendous strike. Pembridge is on his way here. Now, Besant claims he didn't take the player out, but the referee says he did. Jones and Besant can argue all they like. Raya, 2-0 as easy as you like from the penalty spot. Oh, Telfer's got a little bit of space here. That'll be a penalty and possibly a sending off. Well, Besant's already been defeated once from the penalty spot. Harford, the frame of the goal saves Chelsea, but they're still two behind. Jones, a bit of space now, which Boyd can exploit. Up to the far side, Dixon. Pauline pointing back. That'll be a free kick to Manchester City. Under intense pressure, still managed to win the free kick. Here's Dibble, still 0-0. Paul got it clear. Wise, that's a tremendous long ball, looking for Clive Allen. Four goals now in five games for the new boy. Terrific panoramic vision here by Wise to pick out Clive Allen. Just one bounce and a splendid goal. Well, not long now for Chelsea to hang on. Stoppage time at the end of the game, in fact. Boynton. Sheeran. Oh, it's gone in. How unlucky can you get? Dave Besson had that shot covered as Sheeran struck it in on goal, but two deflections later, the teams are level.
Wise allowed to cross, and it was flicked by Clive Allen towards, he hoped, what was an open goal because Torsted had come, but it just wasn't enough contact to guide the ball between the posts. Excellent delivery from Wise. Torsted confused and badly out of position and led off the hook. Tottenham, of course, under financial difficulties, but with Terry Venables now operating as an executive. It's coming better, but here's Allen. He scored! Clive Allen has squeezed it in. Minutes played, just what Chelsea needed to open up this rather cautious selection by Peter Shreve from Tottenham. And he's been doing this so well down the years, Tottenham know all about him. And he found the gap where there seemed to be none. Chelsea 1, Tottenham Hotspur 0. Dixon waiting by the near post. With Jones for company. Cundy and Elliott coming in from deeper positions. Jones gets it on. Oh! And it seemed a formality for Clive Allen. But he didn't connect. But he scored one. He could have had a hat-trick. And the latest chance, courtesy of Vinnie Jones's excellent intervention there. And Clive Allen was up and down, and the ball passed him by. Lassau, off goes Dixon. Placed by Sedgley. Beaten by Sedgley. Paul Stewart against Graham Stewart. No relation, not even spelt the same way. Here's Wise. He's got the cross in, and the header from Clive Allen. Torsted covering it this time. It was an awkward save for the goalkeeper. The ball was on the bounce. The post was another problem for him. But Chelsea certainly creating the opportunities. Sedgley getting there before Jones. Townsend, Wise, onside. Clive Allen on the turn, and everything is falling for him at the moment. I really couldn't have expected as many opportunities as he's had already. And the family a bit worried that he's only taken one. Walsh. Lining up Stewart, well held by Hitchcock. And Stewart surfacing in the second half as a major threat to Chelsea. But teed up for it by Walsh, and hit with plenty of meat by Paul Stewart. Wise. Here's Stewart. Paul. Paul started with Townsend. Dixon. Seen too much of Kerry Dixon. He's trying to change that now. It's the outside of the goal. Here's a player who loves the limelight of the big occasion. Graham Stewart goes off. Kevin Wilson, the Northern Ireland international, who's a man of several parts, comes on at the three-quarter mark of the match. Clive Allen. Wilson rather running into his path. Clive Allen goes on. And here is Dennis Wise.
Tottenham stopped and looked, but the goal is given. And that's the breathing space that Chelsea badly need. With 20 minutes to go, and Clive Allen, who scored one, has now helped to construct one. Great play from him, and Wise cheekily beyond Tolsvet. And Tottenham this time had no answer.
Dixon, nicked on by Allen towards Townsend. Townsend again! And Wimbledon have a taste of their own medicine. The high hoisted ball up into that Wimbledon penalty area paid dividends there for Chelsea. Flicked on by Clive Allen, and as Townsend hooked it up, Allen fought for the ball in the air. It dropped so invitingly for Townsend. Wise with his corner. Dixon on the near post. Clive Allen poaching inside the six-yard box. Does it again. That's goals now in his last three games for Chelsea. 2-0 they lead. Pashinou. Martin can put the crossover. Looking for Earl. They pulled one back. Will it be enough?
A couple of good results push the Blues up the table to eighth, but they're still not hitting the kind of consistent form that Ian Porterfield would like. Chelsea's uneven form isn't reserved just for the league, but at least things go well in the southern semi-final of the ZDS Cup against Crystal Palace.
But neither side at the moment able to string too much together. Dennis Wise, he was manhandled then by Coleman, who looks aghast at the referee. Elliott's gone forward. And there's Dixon! Oh, a classic header from Kerry Dixon. Oh, that was a great strike. Wait here, because here's Shearer with a golden chance, and he's tucked it away. Southampton definitely won't be content with the one goal. Richard Hall has now got Herring forward from his central defensive role. There he is on the near post there. Falls for Hurlock. That's the second. Hurlock's first goal for Southampton, and what a vital one it may turn out to be.
Still goalless in his second leg. Here's Townsend. Allen. He came through to the serve before Ruddock wins it. And Hurlock strikes it forward. Shearer just might win this battle here. That really was a messy challenge and a penalty to Southampton. Cundy hauled him back. I wonder if there's going to be a sending off here for Cundy. Letizier, 3-0 on aggregate now. Southampton are heading for the final. Townsend, pick out Letizier. Oh, what a great turn by Letizier. That's a great goal. Surely now Southampton can book a place at Wembley. The serve, half a yard for him. They appeal for a penalty off Ruddock. And after a controversial penalty at one end of the field, a penalty for Chelsea at the other. Wise, I wonder if he'll give Chelsea new heart. A well-struck spot kick, but Southampton still in the driving seat. Shearer again, away from Dowie. He's on his his hat-trick here, and Le Tissier has scored three now. Memorable night for Matthew Le Tissier. Floated up towards Elliot Jones arriving and scores on his birthday, 1-0 to Chelsea. Chelsea pressing forward again. Stewart, Wise, 2-0 now. And surely now Chelsea are through to the fourth round of the FA Cup. 18 minutes left of this cup tie, still 0-0. Everton pushed back on the defensive. Everill will challenge for this ball, but that was a very, very high challenge indeed on Andy Townsend, the captain of Chelsea. Allen, he's found the net! Clive Allen with the goal that could send Chelsea into the fifth round of the FA Cup. Struck sweetly on the volley past Neville Southall. Find an equaliser. Here's Bigree. Penalty to Everton. Hitchcock certainly made contact with the Everton winger. This really is a vital spot kick for Totti. Hitchcock saved it. It'll be enough surely now to send Everton out. Chelsea have this free kick, driven up towards the top end of the ground, where Wise has it for Chelsea. That took a curious deflection, away by Tanner. Mulby lost the flight of the ball. Jones, that's a great strike for Chelsea. They haven't won on this ground in 55 years, and Vinnie Jones has got them off to an ideal start. Cracking shot. And Grobbelaar comprehensively beaten. There's Jones again, who really sent this special shot in on that Liverpool goal. Mark Walters. Hall gives chase. And Hitchcock to the rescue for Chelsea. Can expect a good deal of Liverpool pressure now. They're a goal behind. Walters made inroads down the inside left channel. Nobody there to convert the cross. Bob Jones. Tremendous skill to get away from Lassau. Rosenthal! That's the equaliser Liverpool have been looking for. Half an hour in, Ronnie Rosenthal makes it 1-1. There's a foul there on Dean Saunders. Jason Koundé. Townsend not in complete agreement with the referee. Mulby. Hitchcock will have seen that one very late. Almost crept in on the near post. Townsend. Stewart. Wise. Yes. Chelsea have the lead again. 15 minutes from the end. Chelsea on the verge of an historic win. Is Liverpool's 13th match and beaten run to come to an end at Anfield against Chelsea? Well, the answer is yes, if Dennis Wise has anything to do with it. Great interpassing here between Stewart and Wise, ending up with a low, accurate shot to make it 2-1. Burrows. Rosenthal got the flick on Saunders. Liverpool so dangerous in those positions. Ball. And scrapping for the ball. Townsend. A lot of red shirts now behind the ball. Tommy Boyd. Lovely 1-2 between him and Wise. Stewart Grobbelaar made a fabulous save. Chelsea are stretching Liverpool this way and that. Boyd and Wise between them opened up this right-hand flank of the Liverpool defence, and Stewart almost made it 3-1. Wise again. Picking out Clive Allen. He fell over the challenge of Marsh, and Chelsea now have a chance to make it safe. So Dennis Wise can make it 3-1 here. Great save by Grobbelaar. Well, he's sometimes criticised about his eccentric goalkeeping, but that was a first-rate stop.
But they're all memorable. But one at Liverpool, yeah, it was a bit special. Haven't won there for 60-odd years, and to crash that one in, it was really good.
In the search for a big man up front, Ian Porterfield looked upon Celtic's Tony Cascarino, who joined Chelsea in a straight swap deal involving Tommy Boyd worth £1 million. Cascarino made a spectacular debut in front of the home fans against Crystal Palace.
Goldrick has sprung the Chelsea offside trap here. White! Yes! Crystal Palace ahead inside 36 minutes. Jones getting it wide to Dennis Wise. Being penned in though. Cascarino! Yes, the equaliser! 3 minutes from full time. Helped by Stewart. The pair of them moved on to this ricocheting ball and forced Chelsea level. That's one for Letizier to scrap for. Horn arriving here. 1-0 Southampton. That'll boost their relegation problems. Now he missed out. Townsend, splendid strike and a splendid goal. And how ironic that a Southampton old boy should strike so close to the end of the game to deny Southampton 3 valuable points.
Chelsea's home form left a lot to be desired, but their strong performances away from Stamford Bridge meant that they're still well placed, 7th in the table. Meanwhile, there was a tricky fifth-round FA Cup tie against Sheffield United to negotiate before getting back to league business.
Away by Barnes. Just got his place back. Myers, the other left-back. Townsend. Here's Stewart. Plenty of grass. Underfoot in the wide positions, and Stewart has opened it up. And he scored! A superb solo goal for Chelsea. After 24 minutes. Well, Ian Porterfield tries to calm down the celebrations, but there's plenty to cheer about here.
Yeah, Cal Bradshaw just goes wrong side. But I tell you what, Graham Stewart wasn't going to be standing about. I did see defences hate players running at them. This is what he does, goes directly for goal. Very calm, very composed. That's a great finish.
It's one for Sheringham to chase. Oh, what a strike by Teddy Sheringham. A goal in the opening minute of the match. 17 minutes left, Wise with his corner. Dixon, off the line by Gemmell. would have been a certain goal. Dickens knocks it back into the danger zone. Clive Allen equalises. Oh, Forrest, I'm sure will feel unlucky here. A header cleared off the line by Gemmell. And as Dickens played it back in towards Cascarino, Clive Allen was there with a vital strike. About chasing that, McClare, that's a great shot by Webb, expertly turned away, McClare, that's not going to count, linesman's flag is up on the far side, and Manchester United's joy is short-lived. There's Myers, still goalless, remember, there's Chelsea probe forward, Donaghy will mop up, oh he's turned it past Schmeichel! Manchester United's title ambitions dealt such a cruel blow by Mal Donaghy. Webb. Now Manchester United need a goal. Ince, they appeal for offside. And again the linesman's flag denies the home side. Here's Stewart. Wise arriving, that's a great save by Gary Walsh. Stewart did ever so well to get to the dead ball line and pick out Dennis Wise, who almost made it 2-0. Manchester United desperate for a goal now. Ince, might come through to Hughes, he's done it! 3 minutes from full time, Manchester United a level. An uncertain clearance, Myers might just help out, he helped it into the path of Bart Williams, Wilson makes it 1-0, 5 minutes into the game. Myers has been dispossessed again here, it's time for Wilson to chase, he's got there first too, that's a lovely turn. Worthington arriving on the back post, makes it 2-0. Anderson got it well, Bart Williams makes it 3, all inside 45 minutes. Billy Jones finding Clark now, 6 minutes left, we still await the first goal of this match. Dixon needs support, oh he doesn't, that's a tremendous strike by Kerry Dixon. To turn away from his marker to beat Walton in the Norwich goal. Jones gets it clear. Robson, oh that's a terrific strike. It could be enough to win Coventry the game.
In the FA Cup, things were really beginning to hot up as the Blues had reached the sixth round and faced second division Sunderland. Have been the surprise team of the competition so far.
Wise with the corner. Elliott trying to attack it. Allen turned in there. Dixon in there. Blocked on the line. Allen has scored. Chelsea.
Well, it's no surprise, is it, when the ball drops in the six-yard box, who's here? Paul Elliott does very well to keep it in play. So does Andy Townsend. Drops to Stewart. Great block on the line. But that man, Clive Allen, that's what he's brilliant at. Watch him again. Look at him. Totally unmarked. No one near him. And he doesn't miss those chances.
Well. And it will come for Byrne. John Byrne has placed the header in. And Sunderland get their desserts. And he's scored in every game in this extraordinary cup run.
Wise. Sinclair. Now Rush. There's no offside. And Byrne takes on Elliott. Slipped past him. Besson pushes it out. 1-0 Sunderland. Peter Davenport. Cascarino. Clark. It's a fine ball for Dixon. How did he keep it out? Tony Norman with a glorious save for Sunderland.
Yeah, it was a great cross in there, and the right back's got the wrong side of Dixon there. A great opportunity for him and a good reflex save.
Sinclair. Chelsea beginning to look more like a first division team now. They've got a lot of players in the centre. Oh, and another astonishing save from Dennis Wise's header from really a matter of inches. Norman got to it and got it up over the bar.
Great build-up from Chelsea and a great early crossing from the left-hand side. Terrific reflexes there from Tony Norman. I don't know how he kept that out. It must have been 3 yards out when Dennis Wise did it.
Sunderland at the moment can't stop the supply, but they are stopping the scoring. Elliott. Townsend off the line. Paul Bracewell by the post. It's not Chelsea's night, not yet. We're into the final five, unless, of course, Chelsea score. And Wise, he has scored! Relief. Agony. And Sunderland couldn't see it out, and one was suspecting that that might happen, although Chelsea were running out of chances. Atkinson with the corner. Oh, a fantastic header, Gordon Armstrong! It's back in his grasp.
Here's Whitehouse. It was pushing him back. And Sheffield United will have a free kick. He certainly has been disrupted by this severe wind. Bradshaw will take the free kick. Hodges has come across too. Queuing up in the middle. Hodges drives it in. A Whitehouse! First to react as the ball was deflected to the back post. Dixon. Stewart now. Over hit. In fact, Tracy almost carried the ball over his own goal line. That was a worrying moment for Sheffield United. So Tracy had to be very careful here. Dixon again, flicks it down. Allen flicks it on. Stewart now. Good stop by Tracy. Chelsea close to the equaliser. Wise. Dundee, 1-1. They found the breakthrough at last. Dixon and Jones making a nuisance of themselves on the near post. And Dundee hooks it home. Another wind-assisted clearance. Corks after it. He might have been fouled. It doesn't matter anyway. Whitehouse puts Sheffield United back into the lead. Counted. great strike, and that is a memorable save by Simon Tracy. To divert the ball back onto the crossbar and deny Chelsea an equaliser.
Meanwhile, with the transfer deadline fast approaching, Clive Allen was sold to West Ham for £250,000, and Jason Cundy joined Spurs on loan with a view to making a permanent move.
Hill! Oh, that's desperately close for Manchester City. They came within a whisper of taking the lead. Simpson. Sheeran. Good stop by Dave Besant. So looking for Clive Allen here. Bishop. That was a good ball by Burley. Picking out Stewart. Stewart now. Wise. Oh, mistake by Potts. Nassau. Stewart. And Wise scores for Chelsea. It was all rather frenetic. But Dennis Wise popped up on the back post to give his side the lead. Devenny calling for the ball, and he has it too. Oh, that's a great goal for West Ham United. Scored by Clive Allen, returning to Stamford Bridge. Best with this enormous clearance. By Clark, Cascarino, and West Ham's problems at the foot of the table continue. Stewart carves out the second goal of the match. Clark with that deep cross, and Cascarino with that powerful strike.
After the disappointment in the FA Cup, the Blues continue to promise a great deal, but are failing to put a good run together in the league, which accounts for their ninth place in the table.
Batty for Leeds. Lovely 1-2 with Strachan and Chapman too. Strachan's inside the box. Wallace. It's there! The breakthrough at last for Leeds United. That was an impressive ball by speed. McAllister's broken free here as Chapman waiting. Cantona 2. Chapman now. And the second attempt. It's 2. That. Past Elliott. Oh, that's a terrific strike from Eric Cantona. Leeds 3, Chelsea 0. Chelsea beginning to boss this game now. Good ball into Wise. Bernard. Clark. Yes, 1-0 Chelsea. Nice ripple of passes there. Before Bernard popped up inside the QPR box to send that inviting header into the path of Clark. Way and is fouled by Stachel. Penalty to Chelsea right at the start of the second half. Wise to take it. That should secure the points for Chelsea. Right into the corner of the goal. Stachel had little opportunity to save it. Townsend forcing the ball wide to Bernard. Good cross by Bernard too. Close ball. both hands on the ball. 3 minutes left. Chelsea lead by 2-0. Shinton finding Holloway. That's a nice turn by Allen. And it's a fine consolation goal too. Beautifully rifled in. Daly forcing it wide to Steve Staunton now. Cuts inside Clark and delivers what might be a fatal blow to Chelsea. Wise with the corner. Good flick on by Dixon, and Sinclair equalises for Chelsea. Richardson's free kick. Besant has lost it. Paul McGrath. Besant made a present of the ball to McGrath there. Parker, this could be all over now for Chelsea. Indeed it is. A minute from the end. Villa make it 3-1.
Jones calling for the throw quickly from Stewart. Cascarino made it his. Dennis Wise. We're into the last 3 minutes. Lissot's header. Dixon. Lofted high by Rocastle. Dixon! Oh! A brilliant goal by Dixon. Has it come too late?
The final game of the season only lasted 32 minutes for Kenneth Moncow. A tussle. A playful tap. And a sending off. To add insult to injury, Everton were awarded a penalty as well. Which Peter Beardsley comfortably scored. The 10 men held out until the second half, but Peter Beagrie put the game beyond their reach with a spectacular volley and an even better somersault. One bright spot for Chelsea, youngster Eddie Newton. He marked his entry to the big time with a fabulous goal. So the Blues finish in 14th position, victims of their erratic form, but showing flashes of brilliance which promise a great deal for next season.
The future now looks a lot brighter for the club. You know, the chairman's managed to sort all that out. I'm sure one day there'll be a superb stadium, where Stamford Bridge is right now. And hopefully, you know, over the next few years, you'll see a team to match it.
The fans have stuck by us, something terrible. And the supporters away from home have been terrific. And I can only hope that we can try and improve the team, because we only really want to give them what they deserve, and that's a winning Chelsea team.